As the focus shifts to New Hampshire, there's at least one voting block that's a little harder to pin down than the rest, first-time voters. Most were high school freshmen when Donald Trump was elected president. Now they're ready to have their say for the first time. Cristina Quinn caught up with a few such soon-to-be voters in Manchester to see what they're looking at ahead of Election Day.
At Manchester West High School, students have grown up understanding that their state is special. And every 4 years, just about anyone who wants can get a selfie with a presidential contender.
I've met Sanders, Warren.
Students like Shauna Kelly embrace being in the heart of it.
Biden, Buttigieg, and Booker.
She started young.
Like around the time of the last primary, I went to see Chris Christie, and then I went to see Clinton at a town hall.
Of course, not all the students make politics a priority.
Are you into politics at all?
Not really.
Still, there's no escaping the barrage of TV ads for 18-year-old Maya Gomes Van Pelt.
Obviously, I know Donald Trump, and then I know Tom Sawyer.
Steyer. Mm-hmm. It's okay. Tom Sawyer is also a very famous name. What about the others, like Bernie Sanders, Elizabeth Warren?
I have not heard of her.
It doesn't mean she doesn't care. These students, most of whom will be able to vote in next week's primary, listed climate change, gun violence, racial equality, and border security as concerns. But the issue most top of mind?
Healthcare, because that's one of the few things that I believe we can work really well on.
Healthcare. I believe that we need to do Medicare for all.
I have more strong opinions about healthcare. We want people to be able to support themselves and be able to pay to go to the ER if they need to.
Healthcare, because I know for a lot of people that it's hard, especially myself, my family. And like things are tight for a lot of people.
Issues and policies matter to these students. But this newest generation of New Hampshire voters have come of age at a time when media has changed so dramatically. And with that, so have their expectations about the way candidates communicate. They're looking for something real.
I think that a lot of them have been politicians for so long that you sort of get that vibe from them that makes them feel that they are politicians and they do sort of have that that persona on.
John Durand, a Trump supporter, thinks the president could tone it down a bit on Twitter, but he appreciates the stripped-down style of communicating.
I don't think it's, like, politically correct, but I mean, sometimes it kind of has to be that way. Like, I don't feel like everything should just be, like, all, like, easygoing. Like, you got to tell, like, the honest truth of what's going on.
Perhaps an unsurprising take from a generation that's grown up with Twitter and YouTube. But as Kevin Shigani puts it, Trump's victory illustrates a shift in what voters are looking for in candidates.
I think what we learned from the election of Donald Trump is that a lot of people in this country are tired of your standard 1992 politician who says scripted things.
Words of advice from this next generation of voters.
Cristina Quinn joins me now. Hey, Cristina.
Hey, Jim.
Speaking of changing media, how do these kids get their news? Do you know?
Well, not from the cable news networks, not from network news. BuzzFeed app was one. Well, that was one of the things. Instagram, YouTube. You know, they going back to that stripped down style of communicating. They want something that feels authentic, that feels...
Greater Boston, for example.
Of course. I mean, Greater Boston is definitely in line with that.
Yeah, I'm afraid to ask this next question. Are they all voting, or at least did they say they're all voting?
So the ones who are eligible to vote in the primary, most of them said that they would be.
Oh,
I mean, they didn't say definitely, but I think so. And then as for the general election, yes.
Do you have any idea how many, I hope I get this right, how many young people who weren't eligible to vote for the first time in 2016 are newly, apparently you do, newly eligible in 2020?
So I looked this up. So,
oh, you did? Oh,
yes,
great.
So between 2016 and this year, 69,000 students, 69,000 New Hampshire residents will be eligible to vote. So,
are they being targeted? I mean, is there a campaign that is targeting new first-time voters? I don't mean people who haven't voted through the years.
But are they going to high schools,
yeah,
for example? So I was told that Bill Weld, Governor Bill Weld, went to their high school. Other than
running
that,
against Trump, and
right? No one else has shown up, which I think it seems like a missed opportunity, right? There's this assumption that they won't vote, but it's just like, well, these kids care. Clearly.
Yeah, the one commonality I was thinking that they probably have with voters much older than them is when they said things like, "We want candidates who are real, who are not scripted." Is that was like a common thread throughout all?
Yeah,
this, right?
I mean, I was really struck by that, but it shouldn't be surprising, right? They grew up with Twitter, they grew up with YouTube. I mean, this is the YouTube generation, right? They go online and they have people talking to you face to face. And so they're looking for something that feels authentic.
When you find that, can you call me?
Absolutely.
Thank you. It was great, Cristina. Great to see you, as always. Again, there are just 6 days to go until the polls open in New Hampshire. Greater Boston will be live from Manchester the night before and the night of the first in the nation primary. Boston Public Radio will be live there as well, starting Friday right through the weekend.